Hello everybody. So, this just came up and I thought I'd share this in a video with you. So, let me just note down the bearing to this target really quick. Bearing 082. Okay, so here's the situation. Operation Drumbeat has just begun. I'm off the American coast. And this ship here came into view and it's coming up fast over the horizon, and this is a big one. This thing is very far away still and it's tall. This is a really big passenger ship. I'm going to sink it. So what I just did is, as first step, I have crossed the bow of the ship. So now I know that I had an AOB of 0 degrees at a bearing of 082 degrees. So what I can do now... Let's just keep this in view. So at 082 degrees... I had a bit... In fact, let me rotate this like this. So. I had a bearing of 0 degrees at an AOB of 0 degrees, excuse me, I'm all over the place at the moment, at a bearing of 082. So I know that the ship is sailing on a course of, what is that? Yeah, let's say 8 degrees. Okay, that's their course, 8 degrees. So I'll go on a course of 100. No, I'll go on a course of 8 degrees. Okay. Okay.
Neuer Kurs.
I need to calm down a moment. So they are sailing on a course of 8 degrees. I'll go parallel to their course, although. Yeah, my god, that thing is huge. That will be some nice and juicy tonnage for me. Okay. I'm not risking anything. We are diving. I'm not risking to get spotted by them. It's okay. Of the values. Of the values that we need to calculate a targeting solution, we already have one. We know the target's course. It's 8 degrees. So now we need the speed. And I think we'll just guess the speed. Or estimate it, let's say it like that. We'll estimate the target speed. Yeah, we are diving. But I believe that target is coming up fast. We'll see though.
Diesel machine, stop.
So we are just completing our turn.
Tiefe beträgt 1,0 Meter.
Let's take a listen. Okay, did you hear that?
Neuer Kontakt, Frachter mit langsamer Fahrt, näher kommend. Peilung 1, 8, 6, in großer Entfernung.
This is our target. But what the heck is this? There's a second ship. I hope that's not an escort. Oh boy. Please let that not be an escort.
Neuer Kurs, 1-9 Grad.
I'll try to gain some distance to the ship's course. And Sonarman. So yeah, the Sonarman is estimating near sound contact, moving fast. So this is a little tip for you guys. So if we go to the speed conversions, then you see what is written here. Estimated speed, slow,
neuer
medium,
Kontakt,
fast.
Frachter mit langsamer Fahrt, näher kommend. Peilung 181 in großer Entfernung.
So if your sound guy, when you ask him for a report, says that the target is moving fast, that means it's moving at 30 knots or faster. And I think this ship is fast. This is moving. So there won't be much room for error here. Let's take a look. Can I see a second ship? The answer is no. Not at the moment, but I think this one is so huge that any other ship next to it would seem small in comparison. Right now what I will try to do is I'll get a first speed estimate by using the Ouya clock once the target has crossed this vertical aiming line. Now for that to work I need to know the length of my target, but I think it's safe to say that this massive ship is 200 meters long or even longer than that. Jesus. Okay. I'm ready to do this. So I've started the clock. And I'll stop the clock once the ship's stern passes through this crosshair. Which should be right about now. Okay. So if I look at the 200 meter scale, then the ship's speed is not on this scale. Oh boy. So what I can do now, that was 23 seconds. I can if I guess that this ship is 200 meters long, like this, 23 seconds, he's going at 60 knots. Possible. I still don't see any other ship. Let me get the course. Let me see if we can still hear the other ship somewhere.
Neuer Kontakt, Frachter mit langsamer Fahrt, näher kommend. Peilung 181 in großer Entfernung.
Okay, the other ship that we heard is somewhere on 164. Let's take another look. So somewhere in that direction. I can't see anything. Let's ask my sonarman, in fact, if that is a warship. No, it's apparently not a warship. So there's another merchant out there somewhere. We'll keep that in mind. Oh my god, this thing is massive. Now I really do hope that this is not a hospital ship, because I'm not sinking one of those, but I think that is a regular British flag, so this should be fair game. This should be fair game indeed. Let's turn.
Ruder 3, 5, Grad Steuerbord.
I want to take another speed reading.
Ruder 0.
Now the good thing at the moment is that the sun is not in front of my periscope, so not behind my target, because reflections of my periscope might be spotted by the target. I'm actually not sure if that is modeled in the game, but realistically that would be something that could happen. So I try to avoid it. This is a big one. I'm so looking forward to sinking this. I think I'll shoot a spread of 3 torpedoes at it. At least 2. Depends how confident I am with my speed estimate here. Let's go. Stop the clock. So now it's only 21 seconds. That would make their speed 17 and a half knots. I need another measurement.
Ruder 3, 5, Grad Steuerbord.
I need another one.
Ruder 0.
The more broadside the target is showing to me, the easier this gets. And keep in mind, this is just an estimate. I do not know the length of the ship. Now some of you might be saying, why are you not looking it up in the recognition manual? Well, I try to go without that recognition manual, unless I'm dealing with warships or special ships. Now this one might actually qualify. 20 seconds. That would mean 90 knots. That's a lot. Okay, I'm taking one more speed reading, then we are turning. Now, I have this rule. Usually in the recognition manuals of the time, you did not have these nice cutouts with the ship's silhouettes.
Ruder 0. Ruder 1. Grad Backbord. Ruder 0. Ruder 0.
you only had that for warships or for very special ships, because having a book with a cutout for every single ship type out there, that would be a really huge book. So no one did that. Okay. You had some registry books, but those did not have cutouts. Those had just the name of the ship and specific data about the ship, like the size, the length, the width, and the height, stuff like that. But there was no cutout. So actually identifying a ship was very difficult. Okay.
Ruder 3, 5 Grad backboard.
Okay, this has to be fast now. Let me lower the periscope, tack this up. So I need to go on a course of 278. Heading 278, please.
Neuer Kurs 277 Grad.
Beide Maschinen große Fahrt voraus.
Beide große.
Shift to the front tubes. So my estimate is that this thing is going at a speed of 19 knots, which is a lot. It's really a lot, but okay. I'll be shooting at the starboard side
Neuer Kontakt,
with a
90
AOB of 90 at 0 degree heading. I'll put the range to 1.5. Let's put it, 1.5 should be alright. Speed 19. Jesus. I hope I'm not turning too late. We are shooting a salvo. Tubes 1, 3 and 4. Spread angle we'll set a little bit later. Torpedo depth. Make it 5 meters. Impact pistols.
Neuer Kontakt, Kriegsschiff mit langsamer Fahrt. Näher kommt. Peilung 2, 3, 0. In großer Entfernung.
So yeah, you had no way to have a cutout for each and every ship, mainly just for warships. So I'm trying not to use this recognition manual because it's unrealistic to have a cutout for every type of ship. The exception of this rule are warships and special ships, like for example, I don't know, if I saw the Queen Mary or something like that, yeah, I guess there would be some kind of cutout available for that. Oh, I almost need to fire. Open tubes. This is a nice and big passenger liner, and it is going fast.
Rohr, los, Rohr, los, Rohr, los.
Okay then, now we wait. If he's indeed going at such a speed, I might have overdone it with the speed, actually. Who knows? We'll see. Let's reload. By the way, as you can see, I now have access to the excellent Type 3, T3 electric torpedoes. Okay, here we go. Moment of truth.
Torpedo treffer.
Yes. Two hits. Two hits.
Torpedo treffer.
I missed with the third torpedo. It went ahead of the target. So my speed estimate was too high. I guess it is not 200 meters long. But it doesn't matter. Two hits. That should be enough. That should be more than enough to sink this thing. Okay, now previously a warship was reported in the area. So what I will do now... is to get out of here. Let's check where we are. I want to go southeast.
Neuer Kurs, 1, 3, 9, Grad.
And we are taking a look at this ship. Okay, we cannot see the impacts. But yeah, look at that. Oh, actually, lifeboats. We have already sunk it with two torpedoes. So let's see, what did we sink? Large liner, 35,000 tons. Oh yes, please. Oh, that's nice. That's a good start to Operation Drumbeat. Yeah. That's a good start to Operation Drumbeat. January the 14th, 1942, Operation Drumbeat has just begun, and I've sunk a 35,000 ton ship. I hope it continues like this. Okay. Yep, tortured metal. Now that I've sunk the ship and I know what it is, come on, large liner. Let's actually take a look at the ship's length. Guess it will be in here. There we go. Yeah, the length was 173 meters. Not 200. But I wasn't far off. Still, we can check this really quick. 173 meters and 20 seconds. So it's actually going at a speed of 16.5 knots. Yeah, 90 was a bit high, that's why one of the torpedoes missed. But no problem. We hit two of them and that was all that was needed. Let's take another look. Okay, now I need to know, where is that warship? 6 degrees. Somewhere over there. I think I can, like here, see a smoke plume on the horizon. But I'm not sure. if this is indeed a smoke plume or part of the cloud. But that warship will haul ass to get here. And I want to be far away from here when it comes.
Mit langsamer Fahrt. Näher kommend. Peilung 027. In großer Entfernung.
By the way, that is a very annoying bug in the game. So as you heard him saying, he reported the warship as moving slow in German. He said langsame Fahrt, that means it's moving slow. If I ask for a report here, he actually gives the ship speed as medium speed. For some reason, when he reports on stuff, he's always saying slow speed. I don't know why. So don't rely on that what he's saying. Ask him for a contact report here. Let's take another look at this. Because this is absolutely amazing. And it's sinking already. Actually, I think that the sea is not deep enough.
Tiefe unter Kiel beträgt 107 Meter, Herr Kalloin.
So the maximum dive depth is 116 meters. So if this ship goes nose first towards the button, it will actually hit the ground before the stern section has sunk under the water. I imagine that it will happen like this. Look at these massive screws. Oh, one is gone. Look at this massive screw. Yeah, there it goes. Yeah, so torpedo number 3 has just run out of steam somewhere out in the distance. No problem. Shooting 3 torpedoes to sink 35,000 tons is absolutely fine. There she goes. Now she hit the seafloor. And all that remains is wreckage and lifeboats. Oh, more explosions. I am actually surprised that 2 torpedoes are enough to sink her this quickly. I mean, sure, passenger ships, they do not have the internal compartmentalization as you would see on a warship, so they are much more prone to flooding. But still, this was quick. Right. So much for that. I think we'll stay submerged for the rest of the day, just to make sure that there are no aircraft seeking revenge. And this shall be it for this video. I will turn on the camera, so to speak, again if anything really interesting happens. Yeah, nice big torpedoes. I've actually seen a few of these torpedoes in real life. If you look at it in game, it seems to be pretty big, right? You have no idea. if you see one of those things in real life and see how massive they are, how huge, you begin to understand how one hit of such a thing can cause a ship to sink. They are ridiculously huge. Okay then. With those words, I'll leave you right now, and I'll see you once anything interesting happens, or once I make a new tutorial about something. Bye bye!